All right, bruh fans, here we are again with another episode review. We're talking season 2, episode 8, The Flower Child. I am unsure of when exactly season 2 is going to take their mid-season break. If I remember correctly, just like Ruthless, bruh, season 2 has only 19 episodes, and Ruthless went on a mid-season break after episode 9. And next week is episode 9 of Bruh. Now, I don't know the dates and schedule. I'm just a fan. I just review this stuff as it comes along down the pipeline. So, I'm going to be somewhat optimistic and think that, you know what, if Bruh goes on break, you know, let's say after next week, I would hope we don't have to wait all the way until November like we do with Ruthless to get the rest of the season. I just want to put that out there up front. Not a bad episode. It definitely had there was a lot of potential of setup. I will say that much for next week. But I think this episode left me scratching my head about the motivations of certain characters and the decisions that they made. So this episode was kind of meh. And not to mention, this is the second week in a row where an episode is like only 20 minutes. Now, they done spoiled us within, I think, the first 5 to 6 episodes, with the episodes being like 24 to 27 minutes. So to be reduced back to like only 19 to 20 has me going, oh, wow. I mean, don't get me wrong. It's easy to get through, not because I don't enjoy the show, but sometimes I'm like, okay, I got to watch Sisters, which is like 42 minutes, but 21 minutes because I watch it double speed. It's what I do. I got stuff to do, people. But on top of that, when I see Bruh is like 20 minutes or 19, I'm like, because sometimes I'm just like, I need to get this done immediately. But for the most part, I will say the positives of the episode, we did jump to a few places. You know, we were at Bill's apartment, we were at Mike's loft, we were in Tom's car, we were at John and Alice's apartment, and at the yoga place. So, you know, we went to a few different locations, so it wasn't restricted to just two places, you know, for 10 minutes each. But I will give this episode, I know it seems kind of low, a 4 out of 10, just because, again, there really wasn't too much going on, but during the first couple of minutes, there was a lot going on, but I will get to that in just a moment. So, before moving further in the video, take a moment and please hit like, hit subscribe, hit the bell icon and select all, that way you don't miss out whenever I post content on the channel. And follow me on social media. Links are in the description below. So the episode starts off, because remember last week, John had punched Mike and knocked him out, then dragged him out of the bar to take him home. And I'm thinking, oh wow, so he must start off with maybe, you know, John and Bill putting Mike in his apartment, you know, so he could sleep it off, you know, because I wonder how that conversation, if Mike actually regained consciousness, went when Bill was driving. Because remember, he hates Bill right now. I mean, Mike hates everybody. But we start off at Bill's place, and I'm like, oh, okay, where are we going with this? Bill is in his bed, and Regina just, no, actually, no. Bill's in his bed, and he hears a door open. He's like, wait, who's that? Who's there? And I'm thinking to myself, first of all, what? But then Regina walks into the bedroom again. Remember, the first time, this was what, in episode, at the cliffhanger of episode 2, when she just walked in on him and Natalie having sex. So Regina just strolls in there, and I ain't gonna lie, I'm thinking this must be a dream sequence right now. But no, she's mad, and I'm thinking to myself, Bill, okay, maybe Bill, I ain't gonna front. It feels weird to say Bill, considering the Cosby man himself, Mr. Puddin' Pop, you know, got let out. So it's like, okay, Bill. So Bill is shocked that Regina's there, and she's like, I'm mad. And it's like, you know, I mean, I don't, what are you doing here? What are you doing here? Because of the fact that it's the middle of the night, her and Pam pretty much pulled a high school, because last week's episode was high school, just pulled a Mean Girls routine where they just roasted everybody in Tom's apartment and left. So yeah, I would be concerned to have her just come up in my apartment in the middle of the night not wanting to talk, and she's mad. I'm thinking, this heifer gonna kill me. But no. What does she do? She begins to take off her dress and her tatas are showing. And she's like, I'm not here to talk. I'm here to fuck. And I'm like, what? Because of the fact that when Bill is confused and he wants to talk, it's one of those situations where it's like, okay, because I'm thinking Regina's pissed off she's going to mention suing Bill, but that's not the case at all because of the fact that, well, instead of talking, it was a situation like this.
My body all over your body all over my body, babe.
Okay, so title sequence, but let me tell you a funny little story first. So, you know, it's early in the morning. I want to say maybe about a little past 6 o'clock. You know, I'm just waking up. Folks are getting ready to go to work. Just to kind of give you a breakdown since I'm at home now. Nephew started summer school this week, so my sister takes him up the road to get picked up by the bus around 7:15, all right? So he's gone. My sister's off this entire week, but she goes out to hang out with friends during the day. And when my parents are at work, they're both gone by like 6:45, so I got the place to myself more or less most of the day. That way I'm free to record and it's quiet and do what I got to do. So I figured, okay, let me wake up, let me watch Bruh first. It's only like, you know, 20-ish minutes, and I'll watch Sisters again because last night my mom was snoring because she fell asleep on the couch when I was watching the episode, so I couldn't really focus. But I'm watching Bruh, you know, getting ready. My dad, you know, they're walking past my room as they're going to, like, the bathroom or whatever, get ready. He's like, hey, what you doing? Oh, yeah, just watching one of the shows I review. Oh, yeah, which one is it? Have and Have Not? I was like, nah, it's Bruh. Bruh, yeah, it's a BET Plus show. It's kind of like a male version of Sisters, you know. Kind of, you know, taking somewhat interest in what I do because, you know, they're older and they really don't understand YouTube fully. They just know I make decent money and it's like no questions asked. So, yeah. So I'm watching, bro. And my dad, he's, you know, I think he was grabbing his wallet or whatever from the bedroom. And he walked by and he's like, yeah, what's this show about? Oh, yeah, it's just a show about some guys, you know, dating life and, you know, black men in America, that kind of thing. It's like, okay, so when Regina was disrobing, as I was talking with my dad and my mom came by too, because she was about to say bye before she left for work. Yeah, what kind of show is this? I'm like, whoa, it ain't like that. It ain't like that, because I think they overheard this show is rated M for mature. It's like viewer discretion advised. I'm like, it ain't like this because of the fact that it's... Can you imagine? You're just... It's like those memes where it's like when you're watching a TV show or movie with your parents and there's a sex scene. And I'm like, how do I explain this? It's like, wait, this show ain't like this. It's funny. Because I was just saying, oh yeah, it's funny. It's like Miss Alice, she played in a bunch of the Tyler Perry plays and movies. My mom like, oh yeah, the one who can sing. I'm like, yeah, she's up in here. I was like, yeah. So when Regina just strolls on in there and strips down and gets on Bill, I'm like, I was just thinking to myself, I was thinking, God, just please somebody.
Help me, nigga, help me.
So yeah, help me. But in any case, the title sequence goes off, and let me tell you what the craziest part was. So we go over to the loft and Mike is there, and this fool, you know, I don't know why, but Mike's like body language, I don't know why it is, but as he was like struggling to open the fridge, I think I heard like a you know, like when his hand was kind of like rubbing against the fridge to open it and he got a beer out. And then my parents just like, wow, I can't believe you watching stuff. I'm like, Mom, let me explain. I felt like John talking to Alice or who, like, no, this ain't like, the show ain't really crazy like that. See? So then when Pam walks in, because I'm thinking to myself the entire time, because didn't Mike say, give me back my key? You know, like back in episode 3, but, you know, Pam just kind of strolled in like,
I still have my key. I still have my key.
Nah, she ain't singing or anything like this, but I was thinking that though. Because it's kind of like the roles are reversed. Like, you know, Mike's the one who's drunk, Pam's the one who's sober, for the most part. At least I think so. But in any case, it's like, so yeah, what was that woman's name from before? Like, look, that was Regina and Bill, but you know, we got Mike, and then I kid you not. My dad and my mom was like, what? Oh, so that was Regina. Who's this? Pop off Pam? I'm like, how did you know? And she's like, what? And I was like, well, no, Bill actually made that comment in the last episode. You know, I'm going to work. So thank you, bruh, for making my day start off on the wrong foot. But all that aside, yeah, so Pam comes in and she wants to talk because her and Regina had a long talk. And she wants to be with him and only him. And I love you. And I'm thinking the timing of this is just very bad. Because of the fact that he keeps burping in her face as she's trying to talk. And, well, I love you and I know you love me. And Mike's like, no, all I know is you took my love and you hurt me. You know what? I can't deal with this. So she gets up to leave and he tries to cut her off. He's like, look, you need to stop drinking. And I just love the fact that it's like, you know, she like puts her finger in his face and just keeps poking him on the forehead. Like, I knew I shouldn't have came over here. Talk like, hey, get your hand out of my face. And then I don't know why, but Mike's face when Pam kind of like pushes him and he spills some of the beer, like just, I don't even know where I'm at right now face. It was just hilarious. But here's the thing, though. She tries to leave. But then we got this ominous music playing. And I can't piece together if this music had been used before. But if you're familiar with the Tyler Perry plays, and I don't want to sound stereotypical. Well, I'm black. I could say this. The notion of black people in Tyler Perry is the fact that, man, there's always the narrative of the dark-skinned guy being evil. And then the light-skinned guy comes in and saves the day. Why am I bringing this up? Hear me out. If you notice during this scene, there's like an ominous Tyler Perry music that plays like, doom, doom, doom. Yeah, you're going to sit down. You're going to listen to me. I got to do like my best. If you've seen videos, then you know what I look like. So my complexion is more so like a little bit darker than Reese's peanut butter, but not so black as the Reese's chocolate on the outside. Why am I making this analogy? I need caffeine. So yeah, it's just a situation where it's like, you know, I realize I actually watched a couple of my older videos, which honestly I don't like to do because I record the videos and I got to edit the videos and I post it. But I was like, you know what? I do sound different in my bruh videos and sister videos due to the tone and nature of my review process. But in this particular one, you know, Mike is just drunk. He's not really, I wouldn't say comprehending, but he's not really on the same level of understanding as Pam. But this goes back to why I gave this episode kind of a low score. It's like, but why Pam? Why? It's like you and Regina talk, but it's like, what I'm getting is Regina telling Pam, you know what, girl, if you really love this man, if you care about this man, go talk to him. Tell him how you feel. Whereas I just need to fuck Bill. I don't know why, but that's kind of like, I guess that's what their conversation was. I don't know. Or maybe I feel like Pam is the free spirit of their friendship. Whereas Regina's the more one and done kind of person. When I say one and done, it's like, I want to lock it down with one man and be in a committed relationship. Whereas Pam is the one who wants to just do as she pleases. Like Mike in season one before he caught feelings. So it's kind of interesting when you look at how Pam and Regina handled their respective situations. Because Regina did to Bill, and we're getting to that, what Pam would have done. Whereas Pam went over to talk to Mike the way Regina would have talked to Bill in season one, that is. So Mike tells her to sit down. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. I got to do like the evil dark skin or the evil villain of a Tyler Perry play. The music. Dun, dun, dun. No, so Pam, you're going to sit down. Put your finger in my head one more time. Put it on my forehead. No, I'm going to go, sit your ass down. Sit your $5 ass down before I make change. Now, I want to ask you this question once. What, Big Daddy? No, wait. I'm thinking about something else. Anyway, did you fuck Bill? you know the answer to that. I'm like, Pam, just say you didn't do it. Don't do these word games. He's drunk. No, you know what you did. No, did you kiss him? No, I didn't. I'm like, Pam, you did. It was Regina's plan. You know what it was? No, wait a minute. No. That's right. Mike left before Regina showed up to Tom's apartment. The guys were trying to tell Mike. I think even Bill went over to Mike's place to tell him what happened. It was Regina's plan. But Mike got pissed off. And then when John and Bill showed up last week, Mike shoved them on the couch with Pam, and then he just left. So he has no idea. Not to mention, he had called Regina in the last episode to come over after they're done at Tom's apartment. So I'm like, so is she going over there? But I'll get to that in a second. So it's like, yeah, I know what you're doing. No, you just full of it, Pam. Pam's like, you know, I'm going to go. It's like, yeah, you better leave my damn keys. Dun, dun, dun. And then she throws the keys at his head. I'm like, oh, damn. So Mike gets punched in the face last week. When John's dragging him out of the bar, his head is hit up against the door. And then this week, Pam just keeps poking him in the forehead and throws a set of keys at his head, and then she leaves. So that's it. So then the music just keeps up. Dun, dun, dun. It's like, okay, yeah, I see how it is, Pam. No, you just like all these other bitches in the street. I try to give you my heart and you hurt me. Yeah, yeah, you know what? Yeah, I want to finish this beer. Because I'm alone and I ain't got nobody to tell me what to do. I'm just going to stretch it on my bed and, you know, kick my shoes off because nobody can tell me where to put my damn shoes in my own damn house. And then the scene ends. I'm like, Pam just came over and basically told you everything you wanted in season one. But you're so hung up on your own beliefs of what Pam may or may not have done to Bill, Tom, and whoever else. And you just threw it away. But I don't... This isn't me taking sides, but all I feel is like, if Pam most likely has seen Mike like this before, so she should understand that trying to have an emotional conversation with a drunk Mike is not the best idea. Pretty privileged. I mean, if she said that to me, would I just cope with it and just say, okay, most likely. But at the same time, it's like, I think there should have been a gap between the events of that night and maybe the next day. But that's just my two cents. So we go over to Regina and Bill. And thankfully my parents are gone at this point. So she gets up. Okay, I'm done. Wait, what? Yeah, I got what I wanted. No, wait. It's like, wait. But can you just stay for a while? Can we? Can we talk for a little while? For a minute, anything? No, she got what she wanted. Bill's like, well, to be honest, I wouldn't be worried about finishing, Bill. I would just be worried about you just strolling into my apartment in the middle of the night with no... And I'm thinking to myself, this is TV magic, because I know myself. I am now, you know, you do not want to see me in the morning drooling and everything and shit. So to have Bill must have just laid down. Because I'm like, I can't even lay down 30 minutes without waking up with crust in my eyes and drool on my face. So for him to just be like, who's there? Regina? Undressed? Like Apollonia did at Lake Minnetonka in Purple Rain? Hey. So she gets dressed. He wants to finish. She's done. I came twice, but I did not. Well, that's on you. Bye. No, wait. No. Oh, God. I'm thinking to myself, damn, Bill, you might want to quiet down before the neighbors here. This is just something else. So then we move forward to
the next day.
And Alice just goes into John's room to wake him up because, she wants him to go up to the store to open up for the morning shift. And it's like, well, Ma, this is your turn to do it. And, you know, Alice is like, no, I don't feel like I had a date that ran late into the night, longer than expected. And, you know, John's like, well, dang, the door was double locked all night. I couldn't even get in for like maybe a couple hours ago. But it's like, Alice was basically trying to wake up John like a mom trying to wake up her kid for school. You better get your ass up for that bus come, because if you miss the bus, I ain't taking off work. I ain't going out early to take you to school. That's essentially what this exchange was. And to be honest, I thought by now that John knew who Chrissy was, but let's not talk about that. So essentially they had their back and forth, and John's like, fine, I want to get up now. I need to get my own place. Cause I'm sick of this. I'm sick of her because I just never.
No respect.
Yeah, he doesn't get any of that around Alice, that's for sure. So, it's funny because she's like, did you call Tom? He's like, fine, I want to call him right now. So, John calls Tom to pick him up. He's like, yeah, I thought you'd call. It's like, I'm in my car right now. I'll swing by to get you to go to work. Okay, I'm thinking to myself, like, I know Alice has the car because technically it was John's car, but I think Alice, like, no, I'm the one that took over the payments for it. Okay. I'm thinking, yeah, he might need an Uber or something because it looked like Tom was getting ready to go to work at the hospital. But in any case, this is something they're used to. I would say carpooling, but, you know, John doesn't have a car. So there's that. All right. So Mike wakes up the next morning and he's like, what the fuck? My face is sore. What's going on here? I can't feel my face when I'm with you. I wanted to do a cutaway there, but I don't know how the weekend is on YouTube, so I might get copyright strike. So I had to do an ad lib. So he remembers John punching him in the face and he calls him. And it's like, yo, did you hit me? No, man, I ain't hit you. It's like, yeah, I was at the bar chilling and you knocked me out. No, man, I ain't knocked you out. I don't know what you're talking about. What about? I always say something like, no, it's like, you know, when I was helping you out of the restaurant, you know, you hit your face against the door or something like that. Do you remember that? I'm going to kick your ass. No, man, it ain't even like that. Like, oh, I'm coming to beat your ass. No, I'm not. It ain't even like that. We in Atlanta, you know, Martin Luther King. Like, I'm coming to beat that ass. So Mike gets up, put his shoes on. It's like, Oh, damn. Because I'm thinking to myself the entire time. This reminded me of that episode of Hey Arnold where, what was it? They were playing baseball. Arnold hit the ball and it hit Harold in the head. And then it knocks him out. And then he tells, like, Arnold how he's going to, you know, I'm going to pound you. Which has a whole new meaning in 2021 if you said that dialogue now. But essentially, I think Helga was, like, counting down when Harold was supposed to, quote-unquote, kill Arnold, because I'm thinking if Alice knew about what Mike planned to do, I know she would pull a Helga.
21 hours, 58 minutes, and 14 seconds until you die.
But then again, you know, I don't think she would let Mike kill John because she sure as hell doesn't want to run that sandwich shop by herself because John's dead. I ain't paying for no funeral. And then on top of that, it's like, I ain't waking up early to open the shop. Who else would do it? So, anyway, oh, sorry, hit my table. So, Bill goes to Natalie's yoga class the next morning. I'm like, why? Because he wants to take a class. And it turns out Regina's actually showing up, so it looks like those two are still getting along. And, you know, he's called out for needing to make a choice because of the fact that everything can't be about sex. And I can't believe you slept with me while thinking about Regina. Flipping my page. And, you know, Bill's like, well, no, you know, I want to, you know, oh, you're talking about therapy? Well, yeah, I know a lot of good therapists. No, but I need you. For what? Therapy to heal. Go in the corner. 30 minutes till class start. Yeah, I'll get a blue mat. Yeah, you do that. All right. So cause I was thinking to myself, Natalie, wait, is Natalie going to strip down again? She did it before. Don't take my comment out of context. So, we go over to Officer Grills calling Greg, and I like, they're adorable together. So she calls Greg, and she's like, wait, is it too soon to talk again? Because I had a great night. Trust and believe, I have ruined a lot of potential dating relationships because I called or messaged too early. My text and phone etiquette needs work. Or should I say needed work? I'm talking about like late teenage, early college years, just awful and awkward myself. But essentially, you know, he's like, well, when can I see you again? Well, we're supposed to take it slow. He's like, no, I want to see you again. How about you cook for me? Okay, over at my place? No, but your girlfriends, they won't be there. So Tom's place, well, it does have a nicer stove, so it looks like they'll have another meet and greet, if you will, later tonight. So, like I said, this episode is definitely setting up things for the next episode or later that day. So we get to the last scene of the episode, Tom picking up John, just kind of recapping, you know, different things, you know, about how, Miss Alice is never going to change and, you know, you should cherish the moments with her. And I'm thinking, Tom, where are you going with this? Because apparently his mom is really sick. And if I'm not mistaken, I'm thinking season one when that abused woman was talking to Tom and he would mention how his mom was being abused, but not in terms of being sick. But, you know, he's not worried. It's like, you know, you can tell he's worried, but he's not putting on a show about it. Well, technically, he's putting up a facade about it. I want to see her in a, you know, pretty soon, so it's all good. And I'm thinking, damn, I mean, if I really think about it, this is possibly like the first, like, actual storyline for Tom, because when you think about it, this entire season, Tom has kind of been like the support system. And no, I'm not doing an Obama impression. I know I get, you know, I love you, Obama, but there's really no, well, technically there is one moment where I can do it, but I really only do impressions when they're applicable to the episode. But in any case, you know, he's been like the glue for the Brug group, trying to help out Bill, trying to secure, you know, Mike's faith in his boys by letting him know about Bill and Pam, and, you know, pretty much being just there for his guys, while John is just everybody's punching bag. But they talk about the Mike situation, because at first Tom's like, hey man, I ain't got the money to lend to you right now. No, he like, it ain't even about the money. It's about Mike. You know, I had to knock him out and everything. And he's mad. He said, he's going to kick my ass. Yeah, he's probably going to come to the shop and kick your ass. What do you mean though? Like, he's probably going to do it. But like, why the bros? Why we got to be like this? Like, hey, you just got to let it happen. But I mean, how would Obama say this sentence? You know, Mike, he's like a little strong French bulldog who will nip at your knees, but you'll be all right, John. So he's like, I would have been like, nah, I ain't going to the shop today. We close. And then he brings up the whole black and white thing, and then the fact that, you're black and white, Tom, so it's like you're a mutt. He's like, hey, my white side is very offended right now. So that's the end of the episode, just their exchange. But overall, it was okay episode. I was thinking to myself, though, like, it wasn't like, what was it, last week or the week before, when Alice was talking about how they need to get more customers because it's like the slow season of the year. And I'm thinking, well, why is there a rush to open up the sandwich shop if you really don't have that many customers? Or is it because it's time to open a sandwich shop since we have a lack of customers? We need to be open early in the morning when there's a chance of having any customers. Not to mention, where's Laura, your other employee? It's kind of like in the Oval where it's just Sharon and Kareem running the pharmacy, but then they eventually hire Dale. So it's like, you might want to hire new help, but given the fact they're kind of pressed for money, they probably can't afford other employees. So that's pretty much the episode in a nutshell, The Flower Child. But let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. I'll make sure to watch next week's episode with my bedroom door closed, even though my parents be like, I know what you're doing in there. It ain't even like that, Ma. So thanks so much for tuning in. Make sure you like and subscribe. And if you'd like to donate to the channel, feel free to do so on PayPal or Cash App.